Bless them! Incoming the thing them call the remix by the one.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm super excited about this. For some reason, I'm nervous, even though this is my first video, but that's actually a good thing for me. As you can see, I'm wearing this glittery, crème, smoky eye. I don't really have a name for it, to be honest, but this is a look that you can wear on a special occasion or wedding events. I usually wear this look when I have dance performances, but I also wear it like for birthday parties and etc. But yeah, so let's get right into it.
Okay, so I'm going to start off by moisturizing my face. I'm going to be using the Body Shop Moisturized Cream. This is really hydrating for those who have dry skin. Then I'm just going to apply some tape on the corner of my eyes. This is just a guideline when I apply my eyeliner. And for primer, I'm going to be using the MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. I'm just going to blend that in with my fingers, and then I'm going to set that in with the Becca Powder Foundation.
You get me into the mood. You know that I need it. Right away. You know that I need it. Please believe.
So I'm going to be using the Tarteist Pro Palette. I love this palette. Like, the eyeshadows are very pigmented and they're easy to work with. So for my transition shade, I'm going to go in with the shade called Innocent. And I'm just going to apply that on my crease and really blend it well. And then I'm going to go in with the shade Whimsy and just build that up in the crease. And to get that cranberry look, I'm going to go in with the shade Maud in the crease. And I'm just going to blend that in very well.
Everyone falls in love sometimes.
Give love a try.
And now I'm just going to define my crease with the shade Drama, and I'm going to be using a tapered blending brush. This just brings out the crease a bit more and the look. So for the lids, I'm going to use the NYX eyeshadow Innocent on the lids, and I'm just going to apply that with a flat brush. The outer corner of my eyes, I'm going to apply the shade Bam from the Tarteist Pro Palette. This really brings the whole look together, and I'm just going to blend that in into my crease as well as into my lid, creating a triangle shape at the very corner of my eye.
Trust me and trust me, I'll give it just now. Take my hand, stop and the man on the jukebox, and then we start to dance, and now I'm singing like, girl, you know I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me. Come on now, follow my lead.
Go back in with the transition shade from the Tarteist Pro Palette, the shade Innocent, and this is just gonna blend the entire look. So for liner, I'm gonna go in with the Inglot gel liner. I'm just gonna line my eyes. I'm just gonna create a winged liner. Gonna go in with the liner and just define it a bit more.
I bet she smell like you every day.
Now I just want a bit shine on my lid, so I'm gonna go in with the NYX Crystal Liquid Liner in Crystal Silver, and I'm just gonna apply that on the lid, but I'm not going fully on the lid, so I'm just gonna go halfway. But it's up to you guys if you guys wanna go full out.
I'm in love with your body. Every day discover something brand new. I'm in love with the shape of you.
My favorite, the Huda Beauty lashes. I'm using the lashes in Sasha. They're very dramatic. You don't have to be dramatic, but. So for face, I'm gonna prime my face with the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. And then for foundation, I'm going to go in with Anastasia Foundation Stick in Caramel. And I'm just going to blend that in with the foundation brush.
Sweet and sour and how your family's doing okay. And leaving, getting a taxi, kissing the backseat. Tell the driver, make the radio play. And I'm singing like, girl, you know I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me. Come on now, follow my lead. I may be crazy, don't mind me. Say, boy, let's not talk too much. Grab on my waist and put that body on me. Come on now.
So for concealer, I'm going to go back in with the Anastasia Contour Palette. And I'm going to be using the shade Banana. I'm just going to apply that under my eyes, on the bridge of my nose, middle of my forehead, my chin, places where you just want to highlight. I'm just going to blend that in with the Real Technique blending. And now I'm just going to contour my hollows of my cheek, temples of my forehead, jawline, and I'm just going to blend that in. Very well. So far away from my father's daughter, she just wants her life for a baby. All on her own, no one will come. She's got to save him. Daily struggle. She tells him. Set the contour, I'm going to go back in with the NYX contour palette. I'm just going to go with all four dark shades and just apply that wherever I put my contour. And to set my under eye, I'm just going to bake with the Laurier Mercier translucent powder. I'm just going to apply that on the places where I put my highlight. I'm going to go back in with the Tarteist Pro Palette, and I'm just going to go in the shades with Whimsy and Maud, and just going to blend that in my lower lash line. Single mama, you know it out there. Facing the hard life without no fear. Tell me I know that you really care. Cause any obstacle come, you well prepare. And no mama, you never said tear. Cause you have to set things here. So I'm going to go in with the Marc Jacobs liner and black, and I'm just gonna apply that on my lower lash line. The pops disappear in a wrong bar, can't find it nowhere. Steadily your workflow, everything you know, so you're not stop. No time for your dear. Now she got a 6-year-old. Okay, so for lower lashes, I'm just going to apply the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. He don't know when you're safe when she says, ooh, love. No one's ever gonna hurt you, love. I'm gonna give you all of my. And then to blend the contour, I'm just going to go in with the Benefit Hoola bronzer. Oh, before that, I've wiped away all the translucent powder. Anyway, so I'm just going to blend the whole contour with the Benefit Hoola bronzer and bronze my face. So for blush, I'm going to go in with the Tarte Cosmetics Paaarty blush. And I'm just going to apply that on my apple of my cheeks. Then I'm going to go in with the Anastasia Glow Kit, Ultimate Glow Kit, and I'm going to use a shade White Sand. I'm just going to apply that on the cheekbones. And then for lips, I'm going to go in with the NYX Lip Liner in Nebula. And then for lipstick, I'm going to go in with Huda Beauty Matte Liquid in Muse. And for brows, I'm going to go in with the Anastasia Brow Definer in Granite. And to pop my inner corners, I'm going to be using the NYX Crystal Liner in crystal silver. And that's the whole look, guys.
Jawbreaker, you got 31 flavors, baby. You can get this now or later. Now or later. You can get this now or later. Now or later. Get done with
it. As you guys saw, I am wearing hair extensions. These are the Bombay hair extensions. They are absolutely amazing. They really blend in with my hair. And I don't have eyebrows, and that's because I have alopecia. I had alopecia since I was 8 years old, and for those who don't know what alopecia is, it is an autoimmune disease and where specific body parts you start to lose hair. Usually it's in mainly in your scalp. I lose hair on my scalp. I don't have hair on my arms and my legs, which is sort of a good thing because I don't have to shave, but my hair is a big deal. At one point, I didn't have eyelashes either. But yeah, I've had alopecia since I was 8 years old. I was in grade 4 then, and honestly, it was really bad. It really brought me down. I was always constantly worrying about what other people think. I was always jealous of other girls and their long and beautiful hair. You know, it was an insecurity that, you know, I couldn't overcome. And inside, I always, like, put it, you know, inside I would just, like, build up with it and just, you know, worry about it. And I was always worrying about what people say about me. I was very paranoid. Like, I was that paranoid. People would be whispering, and I would just constantly think that they're whispering about me. It was that bad. And when I got to grade 6, it got really worse. And so my parents decided to shave my entire hair off. It was just a way for them to know which spots were growing and which spots weren't. So I was completely bald. I wore a bandana for 3 years. I was bald for 3 years. And I didn't know what to tell people. I was like, I didn't know. People thought I had cancer. I actually thought I had cancer at one point. But it's not. It's not life-threatening. I'm not going to die because of it. But it really emotionally affected me. And, you know, I just didn't know what to tell people. I was very paranoid. Luckily, when I got to grade 7, I started going to Sick Kids Children Hospital, and the treatments there worked very well for me. So my hair started growing back, and by the time it was the end of grade 8 graduation, I was able to take my bandana off and, you know, be with my normal hair. I had really short hair because it was growing from, bald to thing, but it started growing very fast, and I still had bald spots. It didn't change anything emotionally. I would still get paranoid. As I got to university, I was really even, like, paranoid because I was part of clubs, and, you know, we had dance clubs and we had to wear specific hairstyles. I would, you know, if I had to wear my hair in, like, half, I would be very nervous because, like, see, I have bald spots here and here, and it would show. So I was always worried about that. And then for those people who know me, like my friends, my family, they know me very well. They know that I always wear hats. Like, I love hats. I mean, I love it because, you know, I like wearing them, but main reason why is because I don't have to be paranoid. I can cover my bald spots and I don't have to worry about it. I have, like, a collection of hair. I have a collection of hats. But yeah, you know, hats was a way for me to cover it. To be honest, this makeup channel was just a way for me to be confident and be open with myself and not worry. And I don't want to live the rest of my life worrying about what other people think about my hair and stuff. So this was honestly just a step for me to be more open and to be confident and not worry about what people think. Makeup, I've been wearing makeup since a young age because I'm a dancer, and so for programs we would have to wear makeup. But when I started wearing makeup, as in like when I started doing my own makeup, was grade 6 when I started losing, when I had no eyebrows. I would do my eyebrows every single day. I started doing my eyebrows since grade 6, and what, now I'm at my fourth year of university, so like 11 years I've been doing my eyebrows constantly, every day. I would not leave the house without doing my eyebrows. I would always have an eyebrow pencil in my jacket or in my backpack. Like, it was a must. It was like a ritual that I would do every day. But yeah, that's how I started off doing makeup. And I'm not a professional makeup artist, honestly. I literally was just self-taught. I'm in my fourth year of university, so my first two years, I sucked at makeup. People know that. I'm so bad at makeup, but obviously thankful to YouTube gurus, I learned off of that, and just, you know, I got better and better. I'm obviously not great, but I love creating new looks, and I love collecting makeup, I love wearing makeup. And I'm not gonna lie, makeup didn't really boost my confidence. You know, when I didn't have beautiful hair, I would use makeup as a way to look beautiful, and I think that's why I have this fond over makeup. But yeah, this is who I am, and this is just a way for me. Like, again, what I've said, this is just a way for me to be more secure and not worry about the insecurities, and I hope you guys feel the same way. But yeah, if you guys like this YouTube video, if you guys really learned off of something, or just love the look and anything, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe. It really mean a lot to me, the support. If you guys have any questions, if you guys have alopecia, or if you guys have hair loss or anything else, just, you know, leave them in the comments below and I'll definitely check them out. But thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!